Hello friends, today let us look into an experiment to prove maximum power transfer theorem. Basically all of us know maximum power transfer theorem is a very important theorem in electronics that tells about amount of power transferred from the source to the load. Here we have a very simple circuit which can be used to verify this maximum power transfer theorem. The theorem states that maximum power will be delivered to the load if the load resistance is equal to internal resistance of the source. Now here we have a simple source with the resistance in series and a milliammeter to measure the current and a load resistor to introduce different loads to the circuit and a multimeter connected across the load to note down the voltage. Here actually what happens is if the load external load, this is the external load, if the load introduced in the resistance box is equal to total resistance of the source, then only maximum power is delivered to the load. Now just to prove this theorem, let us design the circuit. Here this is the source. From the source, from the positive terminal, connection is given to the resistance box. From the resistance box, it is given to the milliammeter. From the milliammeter, given to the load. From the load, again negative terminal of the battery. So this is how the circuit is made complete. Here what is done is the source is adjusted to a particular voltage, say 4 volts, and internal resistance as 250 ohms. This particular source itself is having a resistance of 50 ohms. We are introducing additional 200 ohms using this box. From the source, current flows through the milliammeter to the load, from the load to the source. Now what is done here is just by fixing a voltage, say 4 volt at the source, in the source, we have to introduce certain resistance in the load resistor. Say now it is adjusted to 25 ohms. For the given voltage, for the given load, we have to note down the current through the milliammeter. Here the current flowing is nearly 22 milliamps and the voltage developed across the load is 0.441 volts. So now if we multiply this voltage across the load and the current flowing, we can estimate the power delivered to the load. Now to proceed with the experiment, what is done is for the same supply voltage, resistance in the load is increased in small steps. Now it is already 25 ohms. Now let me increase the load to 50 ohms like this. Now for a load of 50 ohms, the current is different. Current flowing is nearly 20 milliamps and the corresponding voltage is nearly 0.8. So for this load, this is the current, this is the voltage, we can estimate the power delivered. Again, the resistance in the resistance box or load resistor is increased to 100 ohms. Now for this 100 ohms, we note down the current here, it is nearly 18 milliamps and the corresponding voltage is 1.329. Again the experiment is repeated for a resistance of 150 ohms. Current is noted, voltage is measured. In this way, for the same source voltage and internal resistance, load resistance is varied in small steps, say from 25 ohms, 50 ohms, 100 ohms, 150 ohms, up to some say 1000 ohms. Corresponding current through the circuit and the voltage across the resistance box is measured. Then the values are tabulated here. See, this is the tabular column wherein you have different load resistors starting from 25 ohms to 400 ohms. And the next column reads the current in milliamps for different loads. Next column reads voltage in volts. So gradually, whenever you increase the load resistance, current also changes, voltage also changes. And by multiplying the voltage and current, we can estimate the power delivered. On calculation, you see that gradually power delivered will be increasing, gradually it increases, reaches a maximum value and again it decreases. This graph explains the actual variation of power with the load. Here the load resistance is taken along x-axis and the power delivered is taken along y-axis. Now initially for zero current there will be zero power. Gradually if you increase the resistance in the resistance box, I mean the load resistance, power also goes on increasing, reaches a peak value here somewhere here and it remains almost constant and then starts decreasing. So this is the point corresponding to maximum power, nearly here in this graph it is nearly 300. Corresponding power is also can be estimated from this graph. So this is how experimentally we can verify the maximum power delivered. Now what about the internal resistance? Internal resistance of the source is nothing but resistance of this particular source along with this resistor. Now how to cross check the values? Now theoretically the power delivered, maximum power delivered is Vth square divided by 4Rth, where Vth is the Thevenin equivalent voltage of the given circuit and Rth is the Thevenin resistance. Now if we substitute Vth square divided by 4Rth, Vth is supply voltage 4 volts, Rth is the resistance, that is Thevenin resistance, that is 200 ohms. So total along with the internal resistance it will be 250 ohms. So Rth is 250 ohms, Vth is 4 volt. So finally we can calculate the power delivered, and this power delivered will be equal to maximum power delivered here. Now we can note down the maximum power delivered as well as the load resistance, and on comparison of the results it will be seen that when the load resistance is nearly equal to 250, means 200 external resistance here, 50 internal resistance, total 250, source resistance is 250. When the resistance inserted in the load resistance is nearly equal to 250, maximum power will be delivered, and that maximum power will be equal to the theoretical value. So maximum power, this is the experimental value. Theoretical value, the maximum power is obtained by substituting in this formula, Vth square by 4Rth. Now coming to the actual circuit, so whenever you are given this circuit with a source voltage of 10 volt, internal resistance 50 ohms and some 100 ohms resistance, 150 ohms etc. This is the given circuit. We draw its Thevenin equivalent. Thevenin equivalent of the given circuit is nothing but a voltage source with a series resistance Rth. So entire circuit is replaced by a voltage source with series resistance across the same load. Therefore it is sufficient if you look at this particular circuit. Now if you do the calculations for the actual circuit, the Thevenin equivalent values are like this: Vth is 4 volt, internal resistance is 50 ohms and Thevenin resistance is 200 ohms. So total internal resistance of the source can be taken as 250. Now if you switch on the circuit and fix the voltage at 4 volt, for different loads currents in the milliampere and voltage in the voltmeter are noted. Now gradually load resistance is increased, 25 ohms, 50 ohms, 75 ohms etc. Corresponding values are noted, and finally you see that initially power will be less, power goes on increasing with the increase of load resistance, reaches a maximum value, then starts decreasing. So this is how you can prove experimentally that maximum power is delivered to the load if the load resistance is equal to internal resistance. Here the internal resistance is 250 ohms. So you see that for RL equal to 250 ohms, maximum power will be delivered. So this is how it is a very simple circuit to verify maximum power transfer theorem. Thank you.